Good morning, everyone. I'm Councilmember Corey Johnson, chair of the New York City Council's Committee on Health. I want to welcome you to today's vote on a package of bills related to tobacco and e-cigarettes. Tobacco has been around for so long that it's become easy to forget the magnitude of sickness and death that it causes. It kills about 1 in 5 people in the United States. It kills thousands of people in New York City every year, and it is incredibly addictive. I can attest to that. To address this ongoing public health crisis, New York City has taken strong steps to reduce access to tobacco for young people and to encourage smokers to quit. Today, we continue in this tradition with this package of legislation. These bills will restore New York City's place at the forefront of this movement. Research shows that raising the price of tobacco reduces consumption, particularly among young people. Introduction number 1544, which I introduced, would set minimum prices for tobacco products that currently lack them, such as cigars, smokeless tobacco, and shisha. It would also establish a 10% tax on these products. This tax is authorized by state law, which requires the revenue to go towards public housing. These bills would expand on the Council's past legislation setting a minimum price for cigarettes and little cigars. We're also voting today on two bills by Councilmember Lander to limit the number of tobacco retailers. Introduction number 1547 would cap the number of tobacco retailers in the city and not allow new businesses to sell tobacco until the number of these retailers is half of what it is today. Introduction number 1131 would prohibit the sale of tobacco at pharmacies. San Francisco has taken these steps to reduce the number of tobacco retailers and has seen great success in reducing tobacco use rates. Another bill that would affect tobacco retailers, introduction 1471, which I introduced, would raise the retail cigarette dealer license fee. A higher license fee would help pay for enforcement efforts against untaxed cigarettes and other illegal activity. Introduction number 1532 by Councilmember Cabrera would require retail dealers of electronic cigarettes to be licensed, easing enforcement of minimum wage requirements for these products. It would also cap the number of e-cigarette retailers and not allow new businesses to sell e-cigarettes until the number is half of what it is today. We're also voting on two bills related to smoke-free housing. These bills by Councilmember Torres and Vaca would prohibit smoking in common areas of multiple dwellings and require apartment buildings to create smoking policies that are distributed annually to tenants. I thank the sponsors of these bills for their leadership, and I also thank the mayor and the Department of Health and Mental Hygiene for their support in these efforts. I want to thank David Seister, the committee counsel, Crystal Pond, the policy analyst for the committee, and my deputy chief of staff, Lewis Cholden Brown. I also want to thank all the advocates who are here with us today, who have worked very hard on this package of legislation for a very long time. Is there anyone that's here to testify today? Okay, so we're going to call up a few folks, and then we're going to go back to the committee. We have Spike Babian. Okay, you may go up there. And Ian Poulos. You have 2 minutes each. Just press the button, make sure the mic is on, and you may begin. Whoever, whatever you'd like.
Good morning, Chair and City Council members. My name is Ian Poulos, here on behalf of Logic Technology Development, one of the largest retailers of electronic cigarettes in the United States. At the outset, we'd like to say that we oppose 1532A, as we did in April at the hearing. Minors shouldn't vape, minors shouldn't smoke, minors should not be able to obtain tobacco products, and everyone should be informed about the health risks of smoking. Logic doesn't oppose regulation on electronic cigarettes. They oppose the way it's being done. I'd like to highlight 3 points while I'm here. First, all retailers should be known, they should be identified, and they should be appropriately licensed. But first, stores that already have a tobacco license should not have to obtain a second license to sell electronic cigarettes. What we would like to see is one form in a check-the-box type of style that would be easier for the city to administrate as well. If you have a tobacco products license, the e-cig license would be considered an extension of that license. Third, we oppose the pharmacy ban. The idea that pharmacies today are only doing things to improve health is very different than the pharmacies of, let's say, 50 years ago. Now pharmacies are more like retailers. They compete to put small businesses in New York out of business. They sell candy, energy drinks, and all these other things that are bad for you and are not meant to, quote, improve health, which was the justification for the pharmacy ban in the first place. And third, we oppose the cap on electronic cigarette retailers, especially the decrease by 50% via attrition. This cap is going to push sales online. Online sales remain largely unregulated and uncontrolled. It will increase incentives for black market sales, increase incentives for counterfeit electronic cigarettes, and it'll interfere with distribution channels, creating artificial pockets throughout New York City. Lastly, it'll undermine economic development by decreasing access to legitimate adult demand. Thank you for your time.
First, I just want to let everyone know I have the flu. We should decontaminate this microphone when I'm done speaking. So I apologize if I'm a little bit under the weather. I wanted to ask Councilman Johnson if he knew how many e-cigarette licenses there are in New York City right now, because you guys want to cut it in half. So I'm wondering if anybody knows how many there actually are, because I hold four of them, and there are less than 20 right now. So what you want to do is you want to cut the number of tobacco retailers in half. I understand that. The new commissioner of the FDA just went out and told everybody that e-cigarettes are a harm reduction method and that he is going to promote the use of electronic cigarettes and make them easier to access. He is going to keep access to electronic cigarettes because they are a better alternative than smoking cigarettes. You guys now want to take someone who only has 20 licenses. If we told you that you could only buy the patch and the gum in 20 stores, and you said, I want to cut that down to 10 so no one can get the patch and the gum, that would be insane. Everybody would laugh at you. Okay? You would say you want to take the safer option and make it harder to get. That doesn't make any sense. Okay? So while we understand the New York State Vapor Association supports, you know, restricting maybe where people can buy tobacco, or maybe, you know, trying to limit children's access, and we, of course, encourage limiting the access of youth to any kind of tobacco products. However, limiting access to adults to get vapor products, which are already widely known to be a less hazardous option, is crazy, especially when there are already only 20 retailers or so that are registered with the city. So you have 20 licenses and you want to cut that in half. You have 7,000, I think we decided last time, tobacco licenses. You should think about that, because that's not really a good way to go.
Thank you for your testimony today. Any council members have any questions? Okay. We are going to go to a vote. I would ask the clerk to please call the roll.
William Martin, committee clerk, roll call vote, Committee on Health. All items are coupled. Chair Johnson.
I vote aye on all.
Mendez.
I vote aye on all, and I abstain on number 1547.
Eugene.
I vote aye.
Ku.
Mr. Chair, may I explain my vote?
Of course, Peter.
I will be abstaining from intro 1131B, which is just related to pharmacy, local law to amend the administrative code of the city of New York in relation to the sale of tobacco products in pharmacy. This one I will abstain. And for full disclosure, I'm a pharmacy owner. I sell cigarettes in my pharmacy, and I will be abstaining from this vote for this reason. In my district, we have a problem with illegal cigarettes. There's an extensive underground network that sells untaxed cigarettes way off the streets. Banning cigarettes from pharmacies will only drive customers to these underground networks, because in so many parts of the city, pharmacies are much more plentiful than convenience stores. especially in areas like Northeast Queens. In addition, the argument that pharmacists should not sell cigarettes because they betray the pro-health philosophy of the store is disingenuous, because pharmacies also sell products that help you quit smoking, like nicotine gum and patches. You won't find that at convenience stores. All these anti-smoking aids are always on display behind the counter, right next to the cigarettes. So every time a smoker buys a pack from the pharmacy, they are simultaneously presented with an option to quit. So with that said, I vote yes on all the other bills except the pharmacy bill. Okay.
Thank you.
I abstain from that bill. Yeah.
Thank you very much. I want to, before we continue the roll, I want to allow Councilmember Lander. We're voting on two of his bills today. I want to give him the opportunity to make a statement to the committee and congratulate him on the passage of these important bills.
Thank you, Chair Johnson, for the opportunity and for your leadership on this package. I'll be brief since I know everybody here is in the midst of voting and lots of us are trying to be across the street in the subway hearing as well. It's just, I'll say, Mr. Chair, it's not that often we really get the chance to do something that saves people's lives. And that's what we're doing today. These aren't simple matters, but that's how it comes down. I mean, whether we'll achieve the 50,000 lives we want or whether we only achieve 30,000 lives, that's a lot of lives to save. And that's what we're doing here. And so I want to thank you for your leadership. I want to thank Commissioner Bassett and the Health Department for working with us on these bills. I will flag we made some meaningful amendments to the reduction on the cap bill to make sure that business owners who have invested their life savings in a business don't have that value fully sort of taken from them. If you keep your business, if you follow the rules, if you don't violate the rules, if you don't sell to minors, if you keep your business, you know, free from those violations, you can sell your business to someone else, to another, and that they can get the license, so you won't lose that value. That's one of the meaningful changes we made here. Nonetheless, over time, we will see the number of places that people are selling reduced, and that's going to help save lives because we know young people start smoking as a result of availability. And in addition, we have seen from CVS and others and from so many independent pharmacies, there is no need for pharmacies to be selling cigarettes and hooking our young people on this killer. So thank you for your leadership. Thanks to the others who worked to make this a really comprehensive package. Thanks to advocates and staff who helped us make these bills better. And I really appreciate the support of my colleagues.
Thank you, Councilmember Lander. We're going to go back to calling the roll.
Councilmember Vaca.
Yes, and if I can explain my vote, my legislation deals with a major aspect of smoking, and that is secondhand smoke. And I do not believe that those who do not smoke should be subjected to other people's smoke. We know smoking kills, and any measure that this council can take to reduce the threat to public health is certainly what I want to do. And my legislation calls for prohibiting smoking in common areas of all multiple buildings. And I thank the members of this committee for their support and the speaker, and I'm going to vote in favor of all the legislation before us today.
Barron.
Thank you. I vote aye and ask to be added to the legislation if I'm not already noted as a co-sponsor. Thank you.
On all?
Yes.
Okay. Carnegie.
Permission to explain my vote? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Thanks. It probably comes as no surprise to people that I'll be abstaining on 1131 and 1547. It would have been my pleasure to have heard those two bills in particular in the Small Business Committee because I feel that they'll deeply impact small businesses. Intro 1131 and Intro 1547 have the potential to profoundly impact the value of thousands of New York City businesses. While we've heard from proponents on public health benefits of this legislation, it's essential that the council has the opportunity to evaluate the potential significant economic harm to so many communities. The fact is, according to a recent study by the National Association of Convenience Stores, that tobacco products are the largest in-store sales item in convenience stores nationwide. In this way, the moratorium on the issuing of tobacco retailer permits to new store purchases in New York would greatly potentially diminish the value of small businesses that are the backbone of so many of our neighborhoods. Many of our citizens have invested untold hours and sweat in their enterprises, and we owe it to them to fully explore the economic consequences of these proposals. It's also not lost on me that these small businesses are the first line of defense against the black market and underage smoking. These small businesses within our community are ones that are legally selling the products and carding underage individuals and preventing them from getting their hands on tobacco products. Once we take this away, we are opening up the black market for our young people. So I vote to abstain on those two bills and yes on all the others.
All items on today's Committee on Health have been adopted by a vote of 7 in the affirmative, 0 in the negative, and no abstentions, with the exceptions of introduction 1547A and 1131B, which have been adopted by the committee of a vote by 5 in the affirmative, 0 in the negative, and 2 abstentions.
I want to thank everyone for being here today. I want to thank the advocates again. And I want to congratulate Councilmember Lander and the other members, Councilmember Vaca, and everyone else who had legislation in this package. And with that, this committee, we're going to keep the is there anyone else to vote? No. So we're going to close the hearing.
Thank you.
Test, test, 1, 2, 1, 2. This is the Committee on Housing and Buildings. Today's date is August 8th, 2017, being recorded by Mackenzie Joseph.
1, 2, 3, testing 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. 1, 1, 1. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3.